I decided that I am going to do my 2014 favorites. How does that sound? Good? I sound like a loser. Here we go. Hey guys, it's Jacqueline. I thought that... Why can I not speak? Hey guys, it's Jacqueline. I decided that today I'm going to film my 2014 favorite beauty products or hair, skincare, anything like that. And then also kind of tying in my January favorites because January is almost over. Whoa. But yeah, so let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that I use when I do my makeup is primer. And what I've really been loving, I actually only got it probably in like December because my brother's wedding was in January and I mean I was shopping for Christmas presents and came out with presents for myself, which always happens. It's a trap. But anyways, I've really been loving, if you can see that, I think, Smashbox, their photo finish primer, and it's pore minimizing, and I have oilier skin, so it really helps also to keep your face like matte for longer throughout the day. Sorry, this nail's a little bad. But anyways, so it just goes on like so. And it just has like a really creamy finish. I don't know if you can even see that at all. Probably not because it is my skin color. But it just rubs in so smooth. Like the texture of it, I can't even explain it. It's like you're putting on something and it like immediately turns like silky on your skin. I don't know, it's such a weird texture to explain, but once you put it on your face, you're like, whoa. Anywho, so that makes my makeup last a whole lot longer and stay matter, which I love because I don't need no oil on my face. Okay. Next, going with concealer, I use this little bad boy every single day. And it is MAC's Pro Longwear Concealer, and I use it in the shade NC15. So what I use with this is, what most everyone uses it for, is for an under eye concealer. Ooh, got some flakes. So when you pack it on, you just like put it on under your eye, but then you take it down to a triangle formation because if you're taking it out here, it's just pulling the skin away and causing wrinkles. And so you always want to make sure you're like patting in at the end. And when you take it down, it creates a really nice highlight because you don't really want to highlight out here, you know, you want to bring it down so your eyes look wide and awake. And also, technically, I mean, you can use this for whatever you want. So I always, I also use it with this brush from MAC. Looks like that little bad boy. It's the MAC 287 brush, and I use this for concealing any like blemishes or red spots. I'll do like around my nose, little spots that I see. I don't use it to apply my under eye concealer. I just strictly use it to buff out any of those areas. And it works great because if you can see the brushes or the bristles right on top are really like airy, and then it's dense at the bottom. So when you're putting it on and covering a blemish, it doesn't cake on like really dark. It still like, it evens it out and you can't really tell that you're covering up something. You know what I'm talking about. So next, I don't like to use liquid foundation just because I have oily skin and I don't really like the way that it feels on my skin. It just kind of feels like it's just like sitting there like, you know, just like cake and you can feel it, and I just really like it to feel like more natural. So I use MAC's Mineralize Skin Finish, and I use it in the shade Light Plus, and it just looks like this. And it's a really nice compact to have like in your purse too. But this is great, and I love using this with my Sigma Flat Top Kabuki to put it on, and it looks honestly like just like your rain foundation. It has a great coverage, but it's not going to make you look cakey. So if you don't like the feel of foundation, liquid foundation, I would recommend using powder foundation. I mean, you can find drugstore dupes and stuff for this. I know Maybelline has some great ones. So if you have oily skin, this is probably the route you might want to go. Even though I know liquid foundation does give a really nice coverage. So it's totally your call. But I love this guy, and I have used this probably for about like 2 years already now, maybe even longer. It's great. I love it. So next, for bronzer, I love this little guy, Hoola Benefit Bronzer. It looks like this, and it has this cute little brush applicator, and it's this. Let's see if I can show you the color. It's, whoa, should make it darker. Sorry, the lighting in here is awful. Okay, but anyways, if you have lighter skin, this is a great color because it doesn't go on super dark, and it's not orangey by any means. It's just like a really nice warm brown, and I like to use it for contour because goodness knows I do not bronze my whole face, because everyone would be like, girl, what you doing? Your face does not match your neck. So I just go in here and tap really, really lightly, like barely any product at all, and I just chisel out my cheekbones right underneath to contour. I use it as a forehead contour. I do it on the sides of my nose and my jawline, and it just really chisels out your face and just gives it like another dimension, so it's not so flat looking. And it's great if you have lighter skin. Highly recommend it. Yeah. Okay. Next is blush. So, shout out to my girl Katie, my brother's girlfriend. She got this blush, the Too Faced, does it have a name? Sweethearts Collection. Perfect Flush Blush. And this is in Peach Beach, and it is so pretty. Oh my god. Just look at that. Like, oh, pinks and golds, and just gorgeous. There, you can see it on there a little bit, barely at all, but whoa, it's so gorgeous, and it just gives you like a really nice sheen, like a natural glow, but you can still use it with a highlighter because it's not sparkly or anything, and it's not like super glowy, what I like, because it's still matte, but it also just has a beautiful shimmer, and the color is just gorgeous. If you want just like a peachy pink, well, I guess I don't have my shapes because I can't put this back together right. Okay, and then next, I also got this blush over Christmas from my Aunt Louise. She's my godmother. And it is a Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush in Blushing Bride. And it is, wait, why can I not figure this out? There we go. It is in the shade Blushy Bright. I already said that. Girl, what are you doing? And it is beautiful. It has like a purple tone in it. So it's a pinky purple, and it just gives you a really natural flush. I'm looking at myself in the mirror. Mm-hmm. And it's gorgeous. Okay. Next is highlighter. This highlighter is amazeballs. Okay, people, everyone needs to go get this highlighter because it's so good. Ready for it?
Yeah, I know. Just like, ugh. Ugh. Okay, I'll stop with the sounds. They sound crazy. I don't know, this... You can't even appreciate how beautiful it is on the screen. But whoa, I mean, you can sort of see it on my finger here. It is just so beautiful. It's gonna give you like a really beautiful glow. And what I like to use it for is just on top of my cheekbones. I highlight there, and then I do on the bridge of my nose, the Cupid's bow, just a little tiny bit of my chin and forehead, so it doesn't look like, you know, you're like greasy shiny, but like just a really natural glow shiny. Yeah. Next is this guy. Whoa, I use this so much. I think this is my second one, and it lasts a long time. This is from Rimmel London, and it's the Scandal Eyes Waterproof in Nude 005. And as you can see, it's just a nude liner, nothing crazy. I mean, I just use it on like my inner waterline, just like right in there, and what it does is just helps to brighten your eyes and make you look like you're awake. So college students out there, this is your best friend when you get no sleep. Makes you look like you're wide awake and you're ready to go without, you know, looking like a dragon and like super tired, especially days after you've been crying a lot and your eyes are super puffy and stuff. This guy, miracle worker. Yeah. Next would be eyebrows. Okay, so this year, well, last year, right when I got home from Christmas break, I decided that I was gonna go red. So I dyed my hair, which, whoa, it was such a long process because my hair had never been dyed before, and it was really super healthy, and it did not want to hold on to any color whatsoever. So we dyed it 3 different times, with actually like different color reds each time, because they just like, the first time, no color, like Zippo, nada, you saw nothing. And then the second time, we used like a different color red, and my hair was literally bright orange, like bright orange. It was awful. And then finally the third time, 5 hours later, it turned out this beautiful like red brown color, and that's what I was looking for, so I was so pleased. But I did not decide to dye my eyebrows because I just don't think it really looks that natural, like especially with redheads. Like, you don't really see many redheads with like red eyebrows necessarily. It's more like, you know, like a brownie red, or I guess some of them have like blonde if you're like orange hair. But this I just got from MAC, of course, I'm sorry. And the name of it is Redhead. And my mom is a redhead, and she used this, and I was like, okay, whoa, my eyebrows do not match my hair. I needed something that day I dyed my hair. And I tried out this pencil, and I really, really liked it. And here, I'll just show you the shade. It's not even this dark. This is me running my pencil back and forth, but it just is a really pretty red brown, and it's super light, which is nice because my eyebrows are weird and they like to just like take the color instantly and make them like super dark. So even if I put barely anything on them, they're like eyebrows. And so this is great because it goes on super lightly, and then it has this little spool on the opposite side, and you just buff out. So like, you can make like harsh lines and stuff and just like completely buff them out. I'm all about the buffing, girl. All right, so next, mascara. Before I say anything about eyelashes in general, mine are real. And I know you probably hate me for saying that, but I never wear false eyelashes, and I just, mine are already so long that I don't have to worry about that. I know this is like, I'm complaining about nothing, but I just don't like the feel of fake eyelashes, and I'm a dancer, so like whenever I have a show or like recitals or whatever, I never wear them, and I just cake up my eyelashes to make them super duper long and fake, but they're real, so I'm sorry. But, I mean, you can try out this mascara and maybe they'll look like mine, I don't know, because I freaking love it. It is the Maybelline Pumped Up Colossal. And before I use this, I use their, what is it, just regular Colossal. It's the yellow tube. And I really like that, but the brush was small, and I am a huge fan of big brushes just because I really think they give you a lot of volume. And I also don't like the spiky little plastic brushes because, I don't know, I just don't think that they coat as nicely as, like, a fiber, you know, like, actual, like, bristle like that. But, so that's, like, the size of it, and it's just really nice and big, and will give you a lot of volume, and it tapers down the middle. Sometimes it is a little bit hard to get, the inner corner, just because it's, is a little bit bigger. At first, it's hard to get used to. Ooh, my hair is looking flat. But yes, I love this mascara. If you're not a huge, like, big brush person, I would suggest Colossal, and that'll give you, like, the same exact results. It's pretty much the same formula. It's just the brush is smaller. So I would try that out because that's what I always use before this. Okay, so next, I really only included just this as a single eyeshadow, I guess, for favorites, but this is MAC, again. Shocker. It is in the shade Shroom, and it is a highlight, and it's gorgeous. I already hit pan. Tears. But it is so beautiful. And like I said, with all my other products, with lighter skin, it looks gorge. Actually, but this would look great on any skin tone, because it's just, oh, it's just a beautiful highlight, and it's just, like, really pearlescent. And I put it under my brow to highlight the inner corners, and I just pull it up onto my eyelid a little bit, and then just my inner corners. And that's all I do. And it looks beautiful. Okay, folks. Now, makeup brushes. These two are both Sigma makeup brushes. If you don't know who they are, I will put a link down below of their website, and they have great makeup brushes. And I, you know, I love MAC, but I don't use their brushes. I think that little concealer brush that I showed you earlier is the only brush of theirs that I actually use. But these are both Sigma, and this is the tapered kabuki, and this is F86, and what I use this for is just to buff out my concealer that's in that triangle. And always remember to go in so that you're decreasing the wrinkles and fine lines out here. And then also, this is another kabuki brush, the flat top kabuki. It is F80, and it is just amazing. You can use this with liquid foundation, powder foundation. You can buff out, I guess, a contour with it if you want. Like, this brush is amazing because the brushes are so tightly packed. Sorry, I need to wash it. It's kind of ratchet. Because there's so many bristles and they're so compact, it gives you, like, a really nice airbrushed finish. And so I, on days where I want to look more like foundation, I'll go in with my powder and just, but, like, you just, like, push it in and, like, in circles, and it works great and makes it look like you're wearing foundation. And it's amazing. Okay. I'm sorry, this video is, like, extremely long, but, I mean, how can you fit in all of your favorites of 1 year into a video? That's insane, people. That's insane. Okay, next are lips. Now, if you know me at all, you know that I am kind of obsessed with lipstick. Like, actually, that's probably an understatement. Like, I just love lipstick. If I leave the house without anything on my lips, I feel naked and just gross or anything, and I need to have it. Okay. Next is this Lime Crime Velveteen. Whoa. I got this to match the dress that I wore on New Year's, and then I think I also wore it on Christmas Eve. But it is so pretty. Oh my god. Darling. Look at that. It's just like a beautiful vampy red. Has like purple in it. It's just, it's like the color of my nails. Like, just, wow. It's beautiful. That's all I have to say. It's beautiful. It's in the shade Wicked. That's all I need to know. Okay. This lipstick, holy cow, I've worn this so, so much. I think, I don't remember exactly when it came out, but Jacqueline Hill, who is also a YouTuber, who I am obsessed with. That's how I got started sort of being obsessed with YouTube beauty vloggers. Yeah, she's my girl, okay? She's my girl. She, I keep saying a lot. God, I sound annoying. She created this lipstick with Gerard Cosmetics, and it is called 1995, which you can't see because I've used it so much, it's all scratched off. But she created this because everyone was so, so obsessed with finding Kylie Jenner's lip color. Which, I mean, me too, girl, because it is cute. And I'm running out of room. I'll put it right here. It is just this really beautiful mauve-y brown. It's right there. And I never, like, ever wear browns because I don't think they, well, I didn't think that they looked good on me. And I always went for reds and pinks. But I put this on and I was like, yeah. That's a keeper. It is gorgeous. Some people, it looks more pink, and on me, it looks more brown. So sometimes I'll pair like a mauve pink over it just to bring out the pink. I'm actually wearing an under lip color I'm wearing today, which you can't tell. And then two other MAC lipsticks. This is in the shade Diva. I'm very low because I wear this almost every single day. It is gorgeous. Let's see if I can swatch that for you. It is that shade right there. It's just a really beautiful, beautiful, dark, like, burgundy purple. And I'm obsessed with it. And also, Russian Red. Can't go wrong. This is the perfect blue red. And it is just, ugh. It's the most beautiful classic red. Like, if you're looking for a perfect, true red, a blue red, this is your girl. Russian Red. Get you some. Okay, now lastly, I'm sorry, I'm almost done. I'm gonna just show you some of the products I use in the winter that I love and really help you, with dry skin. And because we all know this weather, with the wind and stuff, your skin just gets so dried out. Like, your hands, your whole body, your face starts flaking. It's awful. But this hand cream, it is from Bath & Body Works. It's the True Blue Spa Paraffin Hand Lotion. It smells like clementines, and it's delicious. So I put this on before bed every night, just on my hands, and just bring it up on, like, my forearms a little bit. But, just smell it. Oh my god. It's so good. It's so good. What is it? Oh, it's $18.50. There's the price for you. It's definitely worth it. And it lasts a long time. It has a really nice pump. This gets your hands so unbelievably soft. Like, crazy. Love it. We'll keep buying it. And then also, this is some body oil. Can you see that? It's getting bright over here. I'm sorry. This is the Neutrogena. It's this light sesame body oil. I can include like a link down below if you want to see what the bottle looks like. But I just bought this little spray bottle from Target. It was, I think, like $1.50. And just because it comes in like a squeeze bottle. And I don't think that's super like beneficial if you're just gonna keep squeezing it and it's a puddle and it's going through your fingers and then you're trying to put it on and it's just like a mess. So I like it on a spray bottle and I just like spray it all over, like on my legs, my whole body. And it's a really nice light formula where you're not gonna feel greasy. It's gonna dry like pretty instantly and your skin is so soft. So it is perfect for the winter. It gives you a really nice glow too that just looks really natural and gorgeous, and I love it. So I think that's finally it. I know, guys, thanks for hanging in there with me. Next video I'm gonna do, I think, is gonna be an everyday makeup look that's just super easy to achieve, nothing hard. So you can just kind of, you know, do an easy look on your way to school, on your way to work, whatever. And it is going to be short and easy, depending if you're a perfectionist. If you are like me, like with your eyelashes, it takes like an extra 5 minutes. But it's great. And yeah, so I think I'm going to do that. But also let me know, like on the comments down below, what kind of videos you want to see. Like if you want to see certain tutorials, you know, just kind of whatever. If you want to see skincare, if you want to see like a lipstick, like anything. Just throw it at me and I will think about it. And hopefully I would like to do at least 1 to 2 videos a month. But I know with school it kind of gets crazy. But I'm going to try my hardest, you guys. I'm going to try. So now that my desk is covered in makeup, I'm going to peace out. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I'm sorry it's been so long since my last video. But because I filmed it towards the end of November, then December just got crazy with school and everything. And then it was break and my brother's wedding. And I was just like, I can't film. And I felt awful. But now I'm back. And it's part of my New Year's resolutions to film once or twice a month. So you'll be seeing me. But yeah, I just want to thank you guys so much for watching. And please subscribe down below. I'd really appreciate that. And also leave any comments for me. What you liked, what you didn't like. What products you want to try. You know, what tutorials or videos you want to see, let me know and I'd love to hear it. So thank you so much for watching and I will see you hopefully soon. Bye guys. Oh my god. I just had lipstick on my teeth. Like, during that whole video, that was awful. Just don't do it. Buff it out, ladies. Buff it out. Bronzer down. Bronzer down. Okay. Lipstick on my teeth. Oh, good. And then...